So here at the Church of Arms, we're all about taking pub food to the next level. We have a really small team. I always try and work with them, inspire them. You know, they're young and they're hungry. They want to learn. You know, I've built up a lot of experience working for big, angry chefs, if you want. And here it's very, very different. You know, we look after them and we coach them, we train them. I give them a lot of responsibility here. I left school at 15, straight into Caton College, and from day dot was out to work for the very, very best. I wanted a Michelin background. I worked in Michelin one star to three stars for 11 years, working with the likes of Gordon Ramsay, Marcus Waring, Eric Chaveau, Marco Pierre White. So I put myself there to work for the very, very best and enjoyed every minute of it. In May last year, I appeared on Saturday Kitchen Live with Michelle Roux Jr. and I cooked the most amazing Cotswold lamb with Chipping Camden broccolis, a variety of different ones, and it went down an absolute storm. So today, I'm going to do the most amazing rumper lamb with local broccoli. We're going to finish that with just a few hazelnuts. Really simple, but full of flavour. So we're going to start off by sealing off the lamb, rendering all that beautiful fat out, get that lovely flavour going into it. And then we'd cook the lamb for 4 to 5 minutes, allow it to rest. We're going to pop this in the oven for 5 minutes. While it's resting, I'm going to get some of our local broccoli. And we just cook that in nice salted boiling water for 2 minutes. And we put it in a blender and it goes a really bright, bright green we want it. Mind you, the fields that we're looking over. And then we take some of the purple sprouting broccoli, again, cook it very, very simply in some salted water, and we finish that with the local rapeseed oil we use here. And then we're just gonna make a little roasted hazelnuts, and that just gives a lovely bite to finish off the dish. How we dress the dish, we serve it on some local slate. It's dark, deep grey in colour, so the green really stands out on it. Lots of green on here. So we start off with the puree on the bottom, and then we just build it up. You can dress it however you want to, but the meat is the showstopper, so you have to really make that stand out. Presentation is very, very important. You know, the way the world is with social media, and we can all see everything these days, that people eat with their eyes first. So you've got to get it right. But for me, the most important thing is it can look good, but if it doesn't have that wow factor, then you're not going to come back and have it again. So you've got to tick all the boxes with this. So if you're going to try and attempt this dish at home, it's very, very clear that the lamb is the focal point. So treat it with the utmost respect, look after it, make sure you get that beautiful caramelization color around it, and just don't overcook it. For me, lamb has to be, you know, medium rare. And I just think, even if you normally push on towards the well, then just trust me, just go for it. I love lamb, obviously the right time of year, and we're just coming into that now. So we cook to the seasons, look out the window, you can see them, so why would you not? That's why people are here in the Cotswolds. I feel that I use the very, very best of what's around me at the right time.